Oh, I want to make a field within the grid clickable and then change the data inside of it. So for this option, well, you have a couple of ways of doing that. And the easiest way is probably if I just grab a grid here and I'll open this grid here, grid orders, for instance. And if I just go ahead and run that very quickly, we will see then that we have here a default grid with some fields and some values in there. And there we are. And here I already have the link that I had created during the live session. So what I'll do then is add maybe another link here to the company ID. And then clicking on this, basically, it would then open the form that you want to then go ahead and edit your data. And you can do that then on any grid field application here. You can also do it dynamically using a macro. So just check out the macro documentation at scriptcase.net for that. And there you can add that here within the events, for instance. And then on record is where you would then want to dynamically change that. So it is then applied to each record as it is loaded within the grid application. Otherwise, all we need to do is come here to application links. And we can see here we already have the edit link, which is then the default link, and that goes to form orders. And if you have generated your grid with the connection to the form, then you will already have this one available to you. Otherwise, as I have added here a field link. Okay, so to add a new link, we choose again a field link because we want to add the link to a designated field. So in this case, I will choose then the company ID, and then I will go next, and then I will choose the form which I want to link this to. And in this case, I'm just going to go with the orders because the IDs will match. In many other cases, you may want to create a custom form using a control application, or maybe another form orders just titled differently that you have a different setup view in or whatever you have done there. And then you can just assign the application just by selecting it here, clicking next, and then choosing the variables or parameters that you will be passing from the grid application over to your form, your control application, or even your blank application. Now, if you have more variables or globals associated within this grid application or within the form application, then they will be displayed here and requested if required. Okay, so once I've gone ahead and clicked next, I can then choose how I want that to function. So I could say open it with a modal window, open it in another window, open it in a tab, in an iframe, open it in the parent, and so on. So I'll open it in a tab this time, and let's see then what it looks like, because we already have then one link that opens in a modal window. And now if I go ahead and run then the grid application, and now I will have here the custom ID clickable, as you see. And if I click on that, it in fact opens a whole new browser tab. Okay, so don't confuse the two as a tabbed application within the grid, because the grid has no tabs, right? So with that, we have that open in a new tab, or essentially a new window. It's pretty much the same thing, really. And it's not, isn't it? So again, don't confuse the two. And with that, we have then a link added then. As I said, maybe the best option there is actually to create a custom form, such as here the control or a blank application, and then you can link those to that grid, to that field, to that value, or whatever it is that you are actually wanting to adjust there. So then we have the result for that, of course, and that is to link the field to a form, control, or blank application, or even the grid, PDF, or chart, whatever it is you are wanting to link it to, and of course, set it open however you please. You can even automate it with a blank application, for instance, or another option is Or another option would be to, in fact, have your grid application and maybe think about using here the action bar buttons, because then here you could maybe create an Ajax button that does that increase or adjust that data for you automatically if it's something that, you know, it can be automated. And then you can maybe even create cron jobs on blank applications and so forth. So there's so much flexibility within Scriptcase. It's pretty crazy.